Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavad Gita, Chapter 1, Verse 2. Sañjaya uvaca, drstva tu pandava-anikam, vyudham duryodhanas tada, acaryam upasangamya, raja vacanam abravit. So the previous verse ended with a specific inquiry from Dhrtarastra to Sañjaya. What happened? Kim akurvata Sañjaya? So Sañjaya starts narrating this. Now the warriors are in Kurukshetra. Dhrtarashtra and Sañjaya are in Hastinapur. Sañjaya in this particular case describes the events as they are described in the Bhishma Parva of the Mahabharata. So the Bhagavad Gita generally is chapters 23 to 40, or in some versions of the Mahabharata, chapters 25 to 42. Some numbers change because in different places the numbering system is different. But the events just before the battle was about to start are going to be described now. So two armies have assembled on the battlefield and they are facing each other, and Duryodhana beholds the forces of the Kaurava, of the Pandavas, and his response is given. So Sanjay uvacha, Sanjay speaks, drishtva tu pandava anikam. So drishtva, he sees the Pandavas, yudham, their phalanxes, their military formations. Just like in a cricket match, a batsman has a stance. Some batsmen, by their stance itself, it's understood that this is an aggressive batsman, this is a defensive batsman, this is a left-handed batsman, this is a right-handed batsman, whatever. And depending on the stance of the batsman, the captain of the opposing team knows, okay, comes to know some extent the intentions or the strategies of the batsman, and accordingly, the captain sets the field, and the ball, the captain and the bowler come up with a strategy of how the bowler is going to bowl. So now, similarly, whenever there is a war going to take place, the military formation gives an idea of the strength and the intention. So, you know, if it's a tail-ender batsman, and if the batsman is just wanting to stay on somehow, the stance will be very defensive. So now Duryodhana was extremely confident that he was going to win the war because he had great warriors like Bhishma, Drona, Karna. He himself was there. So in fact, he was so confident that he felt that there would not even be much of a match. His forces would easily crush the Pandavas. That's why, in order to incite the Pandavas, the previous night before the war started, he sent Uluka, the son of Shakuni, with a message meant to goad the Kaurava, goad the Pandavas. And he said, "You Bhima, you think you are going to kill me, but you know what I did to you? I made you wash vessels in the kitchen of Virat. And Arjuna, you think you are so powerful, but I made you into a eunuch." And like that, he described all the humiliating and distressing situations the Pandavas had gone through. And he said that this is how superior men punish inferiors who have the audacity to challenge them. And similarly, I am going to crush you. So his goal was to incite the Pandavas so that they would have some fighting spirit. The Pandavas and their warriors were enraged. And Arjuna said, "You know, only eunuchs speak words. My answer will come tomorrow with the Gandiva bow." And like that, all the warriors spoke. But now when Duryodhana sees the military formation of the Pandavas, he sees that they are not cowering in fear, thinking that we are outnumbered and outmaneuvered. They are having a very strong and aggressive military formation, as if they are sure of their victory. And immediately he becomes concerned. So vyudham duryodhanas tada. Duryodhana sees this, become concerned. And what happens after that? Acaryam upasangamya. He goes to acarya. So the word acarya generally means teacher. Now within the Vaishnava traditions, the acharya can refer to a very exalted teacher also. It's like we have Srila Prabhupada, there's the founder acharya. But the word acharya generally means teacher. And specifically, it also means a teacher who teaches by example. So Drona is who is being referred to over here, often known as Dronacarya. So Drona, the teacher, and he was, although a Brahmana, the Brahmanas are allowed to teach not just Brahminical skills, but even Kshatriya skills and other skills, because they are essentially teachers. And normally, Brahmanas focus on teaching Brahminical knowledge itself. But Dronacarya had not only taught Kshatriya skills, but he had also mastered them to such an extent that he also used to use them for fighting. So, he was here to fight on behalf of Duryodhana, because he had been maintained by the Kurus and he was obliged to the Kurus. And the real, the currently ruling Kuru monarch was Dhrtarastra, who was basically manipulated by his son Duryodhana. So he was fighting Acharyam Upasangamya, Raja Vachinam Abravit. Raja Vachinam Abravit. He spoke these words. Now the word Raja can have two meanings. This word Raja can be a reference by Sanjaya to Dhritarashtra. O king, I'm telling you this. In Sanskrit, we don't have commas which can point out, okay, this is referring to this. So normally, the commas are position markers and direction of communication markers. So the word Raja here can also refer to Duryodhana. Now that reference is a little complicated because Duryodhana is not himself the king. Although he acted in many ways as if he were the king, but the official king was Dhritarashtra. And certainly while talking with Dhritarashtra, normally Duryodhana would not consider himself to be the king because he showed some normal respect at least to his father. So Baldev Vidyabhushan explained that this Raja here can refer not just to king but Rajaniti, one who does and who is expert in Rajaniti, in diplomacy, in politics. Such a person is called Raja. So he went to Dronacharya, Vachanam Abravit. He spoke these words. Now, there will be no Duryodhan uvaca in the next verse because abravit is already included over here. Now, what does this signify? Now, if we look at the line of command, Bhishma is older in age to Drona and Bhishma is also the commander. Drona became the commander on the 11th day after Drona fell on the 10th, after Bhishma fell on the 10th day. So when Bhishma is the commander at that time, why is it that Duryodhana, instead of going to Bhishma for consultation or for cautioning or for inside or for directing, whatever, why does he go to Drona? Now we will see that Duryodhana was always suspicious about the commitment of Bhishma, Drona, Kripa, especially Bhishma and Drona, because he knew that they were affectionate towards the Pandavas. So he of course wanted them to fight on his side and he knew they were formidable warriors, but he wanted to increase their commitment to him. And for that purpose, now there was Bhishma and there was Drona. Now Bhishma was vow bound that he would always protect the a ruling monarch of the Kuru dynasty. So he, when he took that vow, would probably never have thought that a day would come when the Kuru dynasty's descendants itself would be fighting against each other, and he would be pitted on a side he would not have liked to fight. Duryodhana and Dhrtarastra happened to be the reigning pair, and he had to fight on their behalf. But at least because Bhishma was bound by vow, so Bhishma's commitment was sure. But Drona was not exactly bound by any vow of that magnitude. Yes, when Drona had been in immense poverty at that time, the Kuru dynasty had sheltered him, had remunerated him, had honored him, and had given him the facility by which he had become a celebrated martial teacher, not just in the Kuru kingdom, but practically among all the warriors of his times who would come to him for training. So he was definitely grateful to the Kuru kingdom, but still he was not vow bound. So here Duryodhana goes to Drona and he will speak in a way by which he will want to burn away whatever affection Drona might have for the Pandavas and instead get him to fight on his behalf, and not just fight, which he's already doing, but fight wholeheartedly, fight furiously. So his next speech in the next verse will reveal how he presses just the right buttons on Drona in order to try to manipulate him. He will refer back to an old rivalry, almost enmity between Drona and Drupada in the next verse. But here, the point is, Duryodhana, he says, observe the military phalanxes of the Pandavas and then goes to Drona. So, drstva tu pandava-anikam vyudham duryodhanas tada. After seeing the Pandavas military phalanxes, Duryodhana, acaryam upasangamya, approaching the acarya, Raja vachinam abravit. Raja spoke these words. So the one who is expert in Rajniti will now be speaking, and his speech will show his expertise in Rajniti, in diplomacy. So a person may conceal oneself if one is well-dressed, but when the person starts speaking, then we get, the words that a person speaks are often windows into the hearts of the person. Because after all, what can we see? We can just see the way a person dresses and conducts oneself, and then maybe we can know what the profession of the person is. But then if you want to know the person, apart from the appearance and the designation, then it's that is largely revealed by the speech. So Duryodhana, he was evil, he was greedy, he was envious, but he also had diplomatic skills. And his diplomatic skills were be revealed in the subsequent verses, wherein from the verse 3 to 10, he will speak about the two forces, the Pandavas and the Kauravas, their strengths, their primary warriors, and then in that way he will speak in the 11th verse also, and then he'll be cut off by Bhishma's blowing the conch shell. Of course, Duryodhana has almost come to the end of his talk itself, and these verses from 3 to 11 will reveal how Duryodhana is Raja in the sense of being shrewd, expert at Rajniti, and that shrewdness is seen even before his speech. It is seen in his action. Instead of going to anyone else, he goes to the person whose commitment he suspects and speaks in a way by which he incites that person, Drona, and thereby tries to increase his antipathy towards his opponents, because right now Drona has sympathy towards his opponents, the Pandavas. But by pointing out that his old enemy is there on that same side, he will try to trigger antipathy that will remove the sympathy. And by that, his hope is that Drona will fight with his full ferocity. So Duryodhana is revealing, just by his choice of whom he goes to meet, is revealing his diplomacy. Thank you.